Good morning, everyone. All right, there's a good morning. I like that. So many of you know me. My name is Katie Luther. I'm the evangelization coordinator here at Holy Family. So the other day, I had a gentleman come to the front office, and he asked me, what makes Catholics different from Christians? Do you think you could answer this? There's quite a few things. But I would say one of the biggest is our belief in Jesus and his physical presence in the Eucharist. Have you ever wanted to sit with Jesus? Each and every time the Mass is celebrated, and any time the Eucharist is exposed in adoration, Jesus is here with us on earth. So I'd like to extend an invitation to you. I'd like to invite you to come and discover why you are unique as a Catholic. We are starting a brand new series called Jesus in the Eucharist. This series is meant to help you grow in your relationship with Jesus. It'll be starting this Thursday and run in the evenings for 7 weeks. We're also starting a book series to consecrate yourself to Jesus in the Eucharist, and this is something that you can do at home. We have several activities planned for the Corpus Christi weekend in June, including trying to plan a procession. This understanding of Jesus' true presence in the Eucharist has transformed my life, and it's the reason why I'm working for a church and I'm up here with you today. So if you want to hear more about the series or anything I've mentioned or about my story, I invite you to come see me after Mass. I'll be at the back table. Thank you.
Hello, everyone, and welcome. Today we celebrate the third Sunday of Easter. We are very, very blessed to have Bishop Robert Fisher as our celebrant this morning. We thank Bishop for being with us, taking the time to be here. We have a special rite of lector within the Mass today, celebrating three men, three of our brothers who are preparing for the permanent diaconate. So we are just very blessed that Holy Family becomes the place where all of this happens today. By the grace of God, please rise for our opening hymn.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Thank you, and good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
As you heard in the introduction, today we're going to celebrate the rite of lector for three men who are preparing for the permanent diaconate. So we welcome them and their families, along with the rest of the congregation. In the breaking of the bread, we know the risen Christ. Ours is the belief in the Son of God who suffered, died, and rose on the third day. In God who fulfilled the promise of the resurrection to us. With praise and thanksgiving in our hearts and on our lips, we begin this Eucharistic celebration on the third Sunday of Easter. And as we begin, brothers and sisters, let's take a moment to acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather us in to the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you continually come to us in word and sacrament to strengthen us in faith and holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
We give you thanks.
calling to mind all those people, all those situations that have been in our thoughts and in our prayers. May your people exult forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
I would like to invite the children who are present here to come now for their own presentation of the Word of God. So here at Holy Family, some of your teachers now used to be like your size and go out and listen and now they're teaching. So some of you pay attention because this just might be you next time. God bless you.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the holy and righteous one and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Into my heart. As I lie down, I fall peacefully asleep. For you alone, O Lord, bring security to my dwelling.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, I know him, but do not keep his commandments are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see. Because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see, I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. And he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you. that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled. Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Those to be instituted to the ministry of lector, please come forward when you are called. Kurt Stephen Kruger.
Present.
David Leo Orth. Jeffrey Raymond Ortrosky.
Present.
Seated. Our Holy Father, Pope Francis, likes to give a summary of our faith in what we call the kerygma, the central message of our Catholic Christian faith, the central theme that underlies everything about who we are and what we do. And he does this in his book, The Joy of the Gospel. He says this, Jesus Christ loves you, he gave his life to save you, and now he is at your side every day to enlighten, to strengthen, and to free you. We have a religious community in the Archdiocese of Detroit called the Companions of the Cross. They take the Holy Father's words and tighten them up into four two-word sentences as a summary of our faith, or the kerygma. It goes like this. God loves, sin destroys, Jesus restores, we respond. So how about if you repeat those after me? God loves,
God loves.
Sin destroys.
Sin destroys.
Jesus restores,
Jesus restores.
We respond.
We respond.
What we're doing this morning is a response to the Lord's invitation. Every time we come together for Mass, we're responding to the Lord. That's why it's so important that we do this, not just on special occasions, not just once or twice a year, but every weekend, because we're responding to the Lord's invitation. A couple of things that I'd like to take from our readings today, two words. The first one is repent or repentance, and the second one is testimony. So often when I hear that word repent, I think of saying, I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I harmed you. I'm sorry that I sinned. I'm sorry. And certainly that's part of it. But repentance is a much deeper concept, coming from the Greek word metanoia, meaning a change of mind leading to a change of our heart. Repenting is something we do the whole of our lives because as human beings, we change, but we change slowly. It takes us time to become more and more loving, more and more forgiving, more and more generous, et cetera, all those virtues that are a part of being Christian. Repent, something we're called to do over and over again. And to never get tired of doing that, to never lose heart in doing that, because we know that Jesus is walking along at our side, as the Holy Father says. He's at our side every day to help us in this process of becoming more and more Christ-like. Our faith is not meant to be something that's kept within the walls of any one church. It's meant to be taken out to our places of work, to our homes, to schools, wherever we find ourselves. We are to take it out. That's what we, when Jesus said at the end, you know, you are witnesses to this. You're to give testimony to this. That's what our call is to do as Christians, to change our world by our witness, by the testimony that we give. Sometimes we're called to do that in words, but sometimes we just do it by the way we live our lives. The Easter message is one of great joy, saying to all of us, sin does not have to have a lock on us individually or collectively. Jesus overcame sin and death by his resurrection. And that's really something to celebrate. It's something to give hope to our repentance, something to give foundation to our testimony and to our witness in the world. These men who are preparing for the permanent diaconate today are given a particular responsibility in the church as lectors. It's one of the steps that they take on the way to being ordained a deacon. But it underlines the importance of the word, of proclaiming the word, and then, of course, living the word. And Pope Paul VI, when they were working on the restoration and the change of these ministries, back right after the Second Vatican Council, one of the things he said was, make every effort and employ suitable means to acquire that increasingly warm and living love and knowledge of Scripture that will make you a more perfect disciple of the Lord. Knowledge of Scripture. The Scriptures ought to be very familiar to us, something that we can make a part of our each and every day. Certainly the stories we hear at Mass become familiar to us because they follow a cycle where we hear them in a regular pattern. But taking time with the Scriptures every day helps us to be that witness, to give testimony. In fact, St. Jerome, one of our great scholars and one of the early fathers of our church, he wrote in his commentary about the book of Isaiah, he said to them and to all of us, that ignorance of Scripture is ignorance of Christ. So by spending time with the Scriptures, by reading the readings, meditating and praying with them, we come to know Christ all the more. So let's all seek to continue our journey of repentance. Let's all seek to be witnesses who give testimony to Jesus Christ in our words, and certainly by the way we live our lives.
My dear sons in Christ, through his Son who became man for us, God the Father has revealed the mystery of salvation and brought it to fulfillment. Jesus Christ made all things known to us and then entrusted his church with the mission of preaching the gospel to the whole world. As lectors and bearers of God's word, you will assist in this mission and so take on a special office within the Christian community. You will be given a responsibility in the services of faith, which is rooted in the Word of God. You will proclaim that Word in the liturgical assembly, instruct children and adults in the faith, and prepare them to receive the sacraments worthily. You will bring the message of salvation to those who have not yet received it. Thus, with your help, men and women will come to know God our Father and his Son, Jesus Christ, whom he sent, and so be able to reach eternal life. In proclaiming God's word to others, accept it yourselves in obedience to the Holy Spirit. Meditate on it constantly, so that each day you will have a deeper love of the Scriptures. And in all you say and do, show forth to the world our Savior, Jesus Christ. I ask everybody to please stand. Brothers and sisters, let us ask God our Father to bless these servants who have been chosen for the ministry of lector. Let us pray that they may be faithful to the work entrusted to them, proclaim Christ to the world, and so give glory to our Father in heaven. Lord God, source of all goodness and light, you sent your only Son, the Word of life, to reveal to mankind the mystery of your love. Bless our brothers who have been chosen for the ministry of lector. Grant that as they meditate constantly on your word, they may grow in its wisdom and faithfully proclaim it to your people. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Take this book of Holy Scripture and be faithful in handing on the Word of God so that it may grow strong in the hearts of his people. Amen. Take this book of Holy Scripture and be faithful in handing on the Word of God so that it may grow strong in the hearts of his people.
Amen.
Take this book of Holy Scripture and be faithful in handing on the Word of God so that it may grow strong in the hearts of his people.
Amen.
How about a round of applause for our newly instituted lector? I believe in one God, the Father the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all that is visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In confident peace and Easter hope, let us bring to the Lord the needs of our world.
that the church may boldly and faithfully proclaim the resurrection of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our holy shepherds in the church, may they always have the courage to confront sin in God's people and call them to repentance with compassion and understanding. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Jesus may open the hearts of world leaders to keep his commandments, leading us into the path of peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the protection of our military members, police, healthcare workers, and all who work to protect us, may they be kept safe as they risk their lives to protect us from harm. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That more men and women will joyfully answer the call of the Lord to proclaim his life, death, and resurrection as priests, deacons, and consecrated life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have asked for our prayers, may God relieve their distress and put gladness in their hearts once again, especially Joseph Shada. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faithful departed, that Jesus may stand before them with his radiant greeting of peace, especially Leonard DiCello. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intention of this Mass, Giovanni Rotondo, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Faithful Lord, your risen Son fulfills our deepest longings and greatest hopes. As we come to know you better through him, show us all the ways in which you save us, all the ways in which you fulfill your promises to your people. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Amen.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Anne and with all the saints of constant intercession. In your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Alan, our Bishop, Robert, your president, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family who have summoned before you. In your compassion, O Lord, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world everything that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Brothers and sisters, at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. We have a few regular announcements, but mainly I just want to thank so much Bishop Fisher for being here. He honors us by his presence. And those who come with him, representing the diaconal office, and to those who are just installed, may you preach the word of God with great glory. This Wednesday at 7, we're starting again a session of The Wild Goose, the Holy Spirit. Sign up now, because God is really changing lives as he's pouring out more and more of his Holy Spirit. He wants to do that in your life. This Thursday, we're starting a new series called Jesus and the Eucharist in honor of the special Eucharistic revival that's going on. You can see Katie in the gathering space for more details. We're doing a whole bunch of things around Corpus Christi. We're doing a procession, and we're doing things to bring more attention to the tremendous gift we have. Our prayer ministers are available over here after Mass, and they're happy to pray with you for anything. And coffee and donuts are after Mass in the activity center. That would be the gym. So you can feel free to stop by. Be good to celebrate and talk to one another. And also, we acknowledge our brothers and sisters at home. You're always a very important part of this celebration.
Grateful for the opportunity to have been with you today to pray and to institute these fine gentlemen as lectors. Grateful to Father Bob for his warm welcome. Also grateful to Father Brian Meldrum, who is one of our seminary professors and one of the teachers of the men who were instituted as lectors. As we go forward today, let's remember to pray for each other as we continue on this journey of repentance, that all of us will continually work at changing our minds to be more and more like Christ, and then by our witness and our testimony, help to change the hearts of all those whom we meet. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord Jesus by our lives.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Santiago.